Welcome to all my wonderful learners. Today I am here to discuss chapter coordination compound. Our learning outcomes are nomenclature. How to write the name of a coordination compound from its formula. Yes, dear learners, we are having some rules. We have to follow these rules to write the name. Yes. What are these? Then after going these rules, we will learn some important ligands. Then some examples we will perform. Yes. What are the rules? Rules are everywhere. Here also. First is here, cation is written, then anion is written. As there are in our inorganic salts. Right? As in inorganic salt, we are having first cation and then anion. Same in our coordination compounds, first cation is there, then anion is there. So whenever we have to write the name of coordination compound, first name of cation is written, then anion is written. For example, here the potassium is the cation and this coordination entity, it consists of anion. So first the name will start from the potassium, then we will write its name. So how to write that? Learn. Here anion is your complex, cation is your complex ion here, and we will write the name from here. Right? So first cation, then anion. Okay. Second rule is that first whenever we will start writing the name of the compound, name of the ligands are written first, then it is followed by the name of metal. So for the simplicity to learn it, I have used an abbreviation and a trigger and trick here, LML. To remember, because how to recall, that is the skill. So LML will help you. Here L is ligand, then metal, anybody to remember. Right? Ligand name first, then followed by the metal. And ligand's name are written alphabetically when there are present more than one type of ligands together. Right? Here so we are having one type of ligand. Right? Homoleptic, this complex. But when there is heteroleptic, that case ligands are named alphabetically. Right, from the name they are written alphabetically. So we will solve example later on. Next is name of anionic ligand end with O. Whenever we will write the name of the ligand, right, negatively charged ligands name will end with the suffix O. For example, here you can see cyanide, cyano. Chloride, chlorido. Bromide, bromido. Chloride, chlorido. These are negatively charged ligands. Sulfate, sulfato. When I will say anion, then as usual their name will be there, right? When they will act as counter ion, then the name are cyanide, chloride, bromide, chloride, sulfate, oxalate, right? Nitrite. But when they are acting as a ligand, then their name of negatively charged are having ended with the suffix O, right? Cyano, cyanide, now cyano, chloride, chlorido, bromide, bromido, chloride, chlorido, sulfate, sulfato, oxalate, oxalato, nitrite, nitrato, O. Now here the donor site is O. So I will write nitrito O. NO2, then it is nitrito N. And this is the charge on this ligand. Charge on this ligand is required to write to calculate oxidation number. Okay? And hydroxide. Hydroxide is now named as hydroxo. Thiocyanide is known as thiocyanide 2 when it is acting as ligand. Okay? And, but this is about the anionic ligands. which are end with O. Neutral and cationic ligands means having no charge, they are named, there are exceptionals are there, for example amine, ammonia, it is named as amine, no charge on it, zero. Water molecule means it is known as aqua, aqua, CO carbonyl, right, CO as carbonyl, NO nitrosyl, this is your ethylene diamine, 1,2 ethene diamine, didentate ligand, right, it is your this, having no charge. So these are some important ligands. So negatively charged are end with O suffix, no change in the neutral or positively charged, but they are having some specific name. Okay, so that we have discussed together. Now, this was, so an exception here also given, water, aqua, amine, right, like this diagram. Next is, if in our compound we are having more than one same type of ligand, in that case we have to use prefix bi, tri, tetra, penta, etc. depending upon the number of same type of ligands, right? For 2 you will write bi, for 3 number tri, 4 number tetra, 5 number penta, and so on. Okay, same ligands will got this prefix. And what if our ligand is complex? Right here, didentate. 1,2 ethane diamine. If such type of ligands are present more than one time, then we will not use bi. Then we, because already bi is there, in the number is there used, right? So we will write then bis, tris. 2 bis, 3 tris, 4 tetratis, like this, right? So this we have to remember for the complex ligand ligands. Okay, and fifth one is our oxidation number. So we have to calculate oxidation number, as we have learned earlier, oxidation number is very important term here. So, and how that write, written? Oxidation number is written in Roman, right? In Roman, in the parenthesis after the name of the element. Metal's name, after metal name, we will write oxidation number after calculation in the parenthesis. Okay? And the last is there, if complex ion is cation, if our complex ion whose name we have written, right, for example here it is cation, this is cation, this is anion, then in that, or it is neutral, in that case we will not change the name of the metal. Name of the metal is written as usual as it is pronounced earlier, like for example cobalt is here, so cobalt name will be written there as cobalt, but figure is there, issue is there, if change here, anion is there, means metal complex is a coordination complex is an anion here, this is the example. So in this case what is the change, metal name is not written as usual, but there is a prefix A is added at the last, cobaltate, right, we will write cobaltate. Okay, so this is the, these are the rules, six rules are there, right, which are required to write the IUPAC name of an coordination compound, and these are the ligands which are generally used here. Okay, now let us write the examples so that these rules can be easily digested. Some examples so that these rules digested to us. Yeah, these are the examples here. First, I have written the formula. So, about its name. Now, let us write. According to first, so first we will write the name of cation. Then, anion. So, cation is here. Potassium. So, its name will start. Potassium potassium, then anion, a name I have to write, right? So first I will write the name of ligand, element, ligand. Ligand is 6 hexa cyano, name of cyanide is cyano. Then this is your metal which is present in anion. This complex is anion. So it is iron. It is iron. But whenever it is in anion, its name is A ended with A. We never write ironate. It is ferrate from the Latin name. It becomes ferrate. Ferrate. Then its oxidation number. You have to write oxidation number. So oxidation number, how to calculate? Right? This charge, this number of atom will appear near the charge. So it becomes plus 4, minus 4. It becomes minus 4. So oxidation number for this I have to assume X. Right? It is minus 1. So X minus 6 will equal to minus 4. So X will equal to minus 4 plus 6 equal to plus 2. So this 2 you will write here, alright, and this is your name, okay, this is the name, name of the compound. Now the name is potassium hexacyanoferrate. This is the name of this compound. Second example, okay, now here in this case cation is the complex ion. And anion is simple, normal as a counter ion. Okay, so its name I will start again, ligand first, then metal. Hexa, because 6 in number, hexa amine. Name you have learned how to write amine, hexa amine. Now cobalt, cobalt. There is, because it is the cation, so no change in the name of the element. So it is cobalt only. Cobalt, then its oxidation number I have to write, then chloride. Now what is the oxidation number? Calculate if it is X, right? And it is a neutral ligand, right? And this charge opposite to this, plus 3. So when you will calculate, you will get a 3 oxidation stage. Right, name is now hexaamine cobalt 3 chloride. Remember, we will not write the number of anions. We will not write that here. That is used only for the same type of ligands. Okay, so simply its name is written. Third example is here. So this name, it is also having cation as a complex ion. So you will start, now there are two type of ligands, right? So alphabetically we will write their name. Ligand first and matter. It starts with the, it is nitrite to O, right? Because oxygen is donor atom. And here it is amine. So A comes first from the name, right? K-L-M-N-O. Okay, it is also coming last. Sometimes what happens, that there symbols having earlier, but we will not never check the symbols, alphabets. We will check the alphabets of the name. So it starts with amine, it is with your nitrite too. So we will write it first. It is 5 in number, so penta. It fits penta amine, penta amine, then nitrite too. There is no gap. And we will write in the small letter, right? We will write in small letter all. Hexa, oh sorry, pentaamine, nitrite, then the donor atom we have to identify here, O. Nitrite, O, then it is cobalt. Cobalt is oxidation number and chloride. And chloride. Okay, so what is the oxidation number? Calculate here. It is X, 0, minus 1. Okay, charge will here, plus 2. So when we move this side, it becomes plus 3. So plus 3 you have to write here. In Roman letter. This is the name for this third example. Pentaamine nitrito O cobalt 3 fluoride. Okay? And the last example for here today. Where is this? This is again cation. Right? So it becomes now pentaamine nitrito. Now here donor atom is N, not O. Here it was O, so I written nitrito O. Here it is N, so I will write nitrito N. Okay, nitrito N, then cobalt. Oxidation number fluoride. Have you calculated oxidation number? So again you can check here 0 minus 1, right? It is X. So here it is plus 1. It goes this side plus 2. So it is 2 here. Right? So like this, you will solve more examples so that the concepts goes in our blood and coordination compounds name we can write. This is for all the how to write the nomenclature. Alright. Last but not least, our thought. Never give up. Yes, never give up. When you are working something, never give up. Because if we get fail means first attempt in learning. Learning, we get some time, fail, that is not, doesn't end all the things. Because end means efforts, never dies. And if you got no means next opportunity. So dear learners, learning is endless and mistakes are our next excellence for the updation for the next new version. So with this, I take a leave. Thank you very much. Wish you all the very best.